Hey there guys, here's my 1300 kilometer review of my KQi3 Pro. So I've had it for about a year since last summer, and it survived one winter in Vancouver, Canada. We don't get too much snow, mostly a lot of rain. Here's just a little walk around. Hopefully it's quiet here. It's the cemetery. Hopefully my shadow doesn't get it too much in the way. Yeah, so overall it's been really solid. Got it for $6.99 Canadian, directly from New Canada, and regular price about $9.99 Canadian. So you get about, I would say, 30 kilometers range, real world, till the battery's empty, and that's in the summertime. I weigh about 180 pounds, and yeah, it's been very solid. Like the motor's been quite peppy, going up hills, maybe 20% grade. It's been pretty powerful. I had the Ninebot G30P Max, and I find this acceleration is a little bit better, a little bit faster, a little more punchy. The firmware on this guy is the third firmware. Three firmwares came out, and after the third firmware, I find it really neutered the performance from a standstill. And when you're punching it to pass people or to go up hills, it really slowed it down. So if you have the stock firmware, don't upgrade it. The only upgrade improvement was it made this light here quite a bit brighter when it's just when you're just driving. But other than that, I didn't see any other improvements other than it neutering performance. So it was a series of three upgrades, one right after the other. And after that, the performance was noticeably less torqueier. And my range stayed the same, so you would have thought the range would have increased because the motor was decreased. But it's stayed the same, I would say, about 30 kilometers. In the winter, I get about 25 kilometers per charge. That's in about, I would say, 5 degrees Celsius. And I was mentioning in the summer, I get about 30 kilometers in about 28 Celsius degree temperature. I would say the frame is very, very solid. Like, it's very, very robust. Like, the latching mechanism here is quite easy to use, and it's very secure. This guy here, just the whole frame is very solid. I've seen some people crack their fenders, so be careful of that. It's a common issue with scooters in general, just from vibration. The only thing I would say was, I don't really drive this in the snow, but they put some brine, which is salt and water, on the ground. And what it does is it really corrodes just the part of the brakes here, just like the bolts. It kind of has like a frosty look to it. So what I did is I cleaned it up and coated it with some ACF 50, which is anti-corrosion. And you can see it's a little bit rusty in here. So that was just from like one season, and I didn't even ride it in the snow, really. One of the mods I did was for the brakes. The left-hand side was for the rear, and the right-hand side was for the front, which is reverse from a typical bike. So I loosened up the cables and reversed them so that this guy here is actually the rear, and this is the front brake, just like in a typical bike. Because it's quite confusing, like just your muscle memory, because I have other bikes and it's all that way. Adjusting the brakes is not too bad. There's two bolts here, you can move them in and out, and also adjust this little coin here. There's another screw that you have to loosen. The only thing I find is if you have too little brake or too much brake, it's not too easy to adjust the tension of the cable, and also this little barrel adjuster. It's not the easiest. It's not really made for people to adjust it on the fly. And up here you don't have a cable adjuster as well, so you have to adjust it down here, and you kind of need three hands to adjust that. It's just a poor design. And also in here too, as you can see, like, it's very recessed just to get into this nut here, or even to these bolts here. You need a really small Allen key to get in there. Because it's I would say designed form over function. And it brings me to another point, is if you have to ever replace this flat tire, you have to take out the whole deck, like in other scooters, there's a series of like tons of screws along here. Pull everything up, rip up this grip tape, and then get the motor cable out. So myself, I never want to replace these tires. I would probably try and get my local dealership to try and replace them for me. Looks too much like a pain. What I've done in the tires is I put some flat out, the Sportman formula, in it. So hopefully that will help with sealing any punctures. And so I'll just kind of go over just some of the mods I've done. So starting from the top, as you can see, there's so many things up here. And a lot of them has to do with riding at night. Riding at night, you need a lot of lights. Because if you buy some of these lights, which are from AliExpress, they're not the best. This is a really wide floodlight. It's huge. It's essentially twice the size of this one, which is a common one you see on Amazon. So this is a nice flood. This one here is from AliExpress. It has a very good cutoff beam, and it stays constant for about 3 to 4 hours, so it doesn't decrease in output. This one here is the E-by-Fire from Amazon. That's pretty good, I would say, for like $30. So it's a good backup light to have as well. So I have those three. I never use the front light here. It's just not that bright, the middle light. The ring light's always on. And then you see there's a couple googly eyes just for fun. And I have a camera mount here for my Osmo Action. And this is just a little barebell. The thing that's one of my pet peeves is if you have some scooters that are driving on the sidewalk or driving really fast near pedestrians, and if you're a pedestrian, it just sneaks up on you. So at least if I'm driving nearby, people can hear me coming. So there's a silencer here. And I also have a different bell, which I was going a little crazy on some of the AliExpress accessories. So it's also like a bell. This one is super annoying though. I don't tend to use this, but let's just say if you want pedestrians to know you're coming, they'll hear you a mile away and they'll get out of the way because they'll be wondering what the hell is that. And over here, it's a bar end mirror. So what you have to do here is you have to cut this thing out here, take off the thing, and then you take off the whole handle. There's a little piece of plastic that's in here that you have to actually ply out with some needle-nose pliers, cut it, and then you can put the bar end mirror. And I also have this little holder here. It's just a little bracket so that you can still grip it and have an extra flashing light for the rear. Because I tried to mount a light down here with a GoPro mount, one of those double-sided tape things, a couple of times, and due to vibration, or even if I cleaned it with alcohol, it popped right off and I lost the light. So I like to have another light here because this light isn't that bright. And if I ride, I ride a lot at nighttime, you want to be seen, definitely. Try to be annoying rather than be dead, I say. Now from the rear view here, you can see this is the Lamicel or Lamical phone holder. It's really solid. I like this. I use this on all my devices. This is just a standard bell here. And you can see here, so for this third light, I also use the same bracket. This is from AliExpress. So you can actually mount more stuff without putting like a big extender bar across the top. And this is the back end of the camera mount. This is that big light I was mentioning. And this over here is the horn. So that's this actual horn down here. So what that's for is if you're in a really dangerous situation, so they say there's a car driving in the bike lane or gonna cut you off, use that. I tend not to use it on pedestrians, but sometimes I've had to ring my bell a few times and they don't move, or they have headphones in and they're in the bike lane, and I've had to use it for that too. So, and the great thing about this is you can actually use it as an alarm. So there's a key fob that comes with it for this one, this version. You arm it, and then if something shakes your bike while you're away, it'll start beeping. It'll start honking at people. And here is just like a laser light. I'll show that in the next part of the video when it's dark. So it puts like a beam going down. I also got a laser light down here too. It's not the most useful. I'd say it's more for show. People don't really notice. This is a Wildman 2-liter bag. So I use it just to hold some odds and ends, some hand sanitizer, some wipes, a tire plug, whatnot. And these two flashlights here, they're actually power banks as well. So I have USB-C coming out. One of them is just going up here, which goes to the phone mount. And then the other one here just goes down to a secondary camera mount. So this is also for the action cam, just for like a lower view, lower point of view for different video. And back to this side here is just a Velcro drink bottle holder. So it has Velcro, it stays quite secure. I added just like a zip tie here just to keep it really secure. And way down here is a little mini USB power bank, which is three AAA batteries, which came with a kit for LED lighting under the board. So it comes with this guy. You could use a different USB power bank. And I routed it down here. Not the cleanest routing, but had to use some double-sided weatherproof tape. So there's the on and off switch and the cycle modes. And I'll show you later, but it actually has two strips that go down below and it lights up. So it was about $30, so I can't complain. It's been pretty solid. And here, which you can barely see, is just some reflective tape. So it kind of looks like a Xiaomi. That's just from AliExpress, like $3. So you just put that all along just to light yourself up and just, you know, add some flair. So the back, only mod I really did was added this reflective tape. And like I was mentioning in the tires, it's just flat out. I used 1/8 of the bottle per tire. So you just put that in, inflate the tire. So yeah, 1300 kilometers so far, fingers crossed, it's been okay. Tire wear is still pretty good. I've driven on gravel and mostly on roads, but it's pretty decent. You can see though, the rotors are getting quite a bit rusty. And I was just driving it in the winter when it was not raining, but it was just a little bit wet and they had that salt brine on the ground. And I guess I didn't clean it well enough, and I didn't coat it with the anti-corrosive coating. So the rotors are a little bit rusty, just a little bit. But overall, the tires seem like they're okay. The hub motor itself looks like it's fine. Slightly scratched, just a little bit. But overall, the deck, it's been pretty solid. Nothing's peeled off, just slightly dirty. But it's nice to have just kind of two spots where you can rest your leg, front, and the back and the front. So you can kind of do different kind of yoga stances so you don't get too tired. But $700, can't complain. It's better than the 9-Bot 30 LP from Costco, the lower range one, because that one only gets about 22 kilometers or maybe 20 kilometers per charge. It's not as powerful as this. Definitely a lot smaller. This beast is about 46 pounds. You add all my extra accessories and crap, that's probably another 5 pounds. If I didn't ride at nighttime, it wouldn't be so heavy. There wouldn't be all this extra stuff. It's mostly lights. So it's quite heavy. And if you're on grass, if you have it tilted the wrong way, it could fall down just because of all this extra crap I have up here. As you've seen in my like other Jetson video, I really load my stuff up with a lot of accessories just in case. Mostly for night riding, city riding, because around 4 o'clock in the fall, it's pitch black and you need as bright as lights as possible. But yeah, I highly recommend it for the sale price, $700. $1,000, that's about a fair price, I would say. I'd wait because New Canada has it on sale about every quarter for 30% off. So you can't go wrong with that. I wouldn't pay full $1,000. And I'll just show you my helmet here. So I kind of did a little MacGyvering of the helmet. So I have this flashing light on the top, which is a little weak when it goes flashing forward, but the rear is not bad. So the flashing light's always on the rear, just reflective tape. And the strap here, which is going to this Workhorse headlamp, this is just for doing work, but it's quite bright. I'll show it later in the night video. It's very bright, has a turbo mode. And I also have this little, it's called a third eye mirror. This is about 35 bucks on Amazon or so. I actually like this more than using the rear view mirror here because it's a little bit low. So you have this on and whichever way you swivel, you can actually get a full like 180 degree behind you of what you can see. So then if you're using different scooters, your mirror comes with you. So you don't need to put these bar end mirrors in every single scooter which you have or every e-bike. You just use one helmet and it's perfect actually. You can see a lot more in the rear view of this compared to using this guy, I find. But yeah, if you have any questions or comments, all the accessories are in the description below. I would buy it again. It's definitely been good for 1300 kilometers. Haven't had to replace the brake pads. Haven't replaced anything on the brakes. Haven't really replaced anything actually. Just added a whole bunch of accessories to it. Ride it at nighttime a lot. You know, I use it for errands. It's nice to just bring into the store. You know, you don't need to like park it outside because I just bring it inside the store with me. No stores have asked me to take it out or leave it locked outside. If they did, I just wouldn't shop there because if you're in Vancouver, someone is going to steal your bike or e-scooter if you leave it outside. Always bring it in with you because the angle grinder is just going to cut it in 10 seconds. So bring it in with you or don't shop at that store if they don't let you bring it in. And yeah, I haven't got any trouble since it's so compact. But yeah, I'll show you just all the lights in the next video at nighttime. Definitely lit up like a Christmas tree. It's super annoying, but super bright. And if people notice you, that's what you want. You want people to not run you over, to see that you're there, and just to stay away. Thank you. Oh, and one thing I forgot to mention. Sometimes when I carry some groceries or I pick up some bubble tea for the missus, there's a little hook here, so it's a carabiner. It's just strapped down. It's from AliExpress, so it's a strap with a carabiner, and it's perfect for putting a bag. Just hang a bag here instead of having to hang it on the handlebars and have it get in the way of your brakes or your throttle. And this little hook here is when you fold up the scooter, and it's solid metal, which is perfect. So if I have something extra heavy, I use this carabiner. So it's a plastic carabiner. So it doesn't actually scratch this metal piece. So what I've actually done is I use this carabiner here and then I have a jug of milk through the handlebar. So you just put this through the handlebar of the jug of milk and then just latch it on here. You got a whole big jar of milk or a bottle of milk. It's super, you know, top heavy, but as long as you don't move too much, turn too much and don't make sudden movements, it's fine. If you're in a pinch and you just need to go get some milk. Okay, so here's all the lights. So on the left is just the flashing rear lights, just to be seen by cars. This one here is the fancy laser beam, which is just more for show. It doesn't really do anything. I also have one on the front here. Can't really see because of the headlight right now. And this is the control box for the underglow. So there's two LED strips, so that's $30. It's just a USB power bank. And here's the main lights. So on the left is the E-by-Fire, three LED. The middle is the Lumen Top, a B01. The right is the new Bowler from AliExpress. It's a 4-LED flood beam. So this is with all of them on right now. This is all on high. So you can see it kind of lights up pretty well. So I'll turn off the lumen top, turn off the new bowler. And so this is just the e-bi fire right now, just on high. So you see it's kind of a very spot beam, so you can't really see too much in your periphery. So I'll turn that off. Then I'll turn on the lumen top, the middle one. So this is more of a cutoff beam. So I have it pointing more forward and it cuts off so it doesn't blind people. The one on the left, the e-bi fire, also have that pointed down, as well as the other new bowler as well. This is the only one that's kind of facing more forwards, just so I can see more in the distance. So it's more of a yellowish tinge, more of a daylight color rather than bright blue. So I'll turn that off. Then I'll turn on the new bowler. So this is the flood beam. And so this is on high. So you see it really lights up a lot. But I have it face down as well because I don't want to blind people. So you can see a lot in the periphery. Turn that one off as well. Then I'll turn on my helmet light. So this is my helmet light. It's probably blinding. So it has a nice kind of daylight color to it, not too blue. And it's great for looking around corners, getting attention to cars. So if you're looking straight ahead, looking at a car that's coming out of intersections, as soon as you look at them, they see there's something bright coming up the way and it stops them in their tracks. So now let's turn on everything again. So that's the e-bi fire at high, lumen top high. That's the new bowler at high. And now you have the helmet at high. So that's everything. And what's cool is you also have a turbo mode. So this lumen top, double tap, a little bit brighter. My helmet, if I double tap, even brighter. You see how much that really lights up. And lastly, the new bowler floodlight, double tap, and you can see everything. Pretty crazy, right? Now that new bowler is only good for a turbo mode of 2 minutes or a minute before it overheats and you get cool down. So I just usually run it in high. Turn this back down and turn the helmet back down. So this is just everything back on high again. And what I do is if I'm going to ride this through Central Park, which we're at right now, I can do night rides here. It's not the safest place to be, so you have to be very careful. So just me being here right now by myself is a little bit sketchy. But I just wanted to show you guys this, all my lights. I don't run them all at the same time. That's just ridiculous. So I usually have turn off the flood. And I usually just run the lumen top and the e-bi fire and my helmet light. So that gives me a pretty good focus beam. The flood is more if you know you're by yourself and there's no one else around and you want to see everything in your periphery, then you turn that beast on. This guy is huge.